Hi, this is Robert Petkoff, narrator of the Star Trek Legacies audiobooks. First of all, I was thrilled when I got the call because I'm a huge Star Trek fan. I'm a total geek when it comes to Star Trek. And so I was very excited because I'm so familiar with the original series. It's my favorite of the series. And so it's been really exciting to do, to prepare, to be able to say Captain's Log, to be able to do the voices of Kirk and Spock and Scotty and Chekhov and McCoy. It's fabulous. I was reading the book and preparing it. I already know the characters. I know what they sound like to me in my head. And I went even as far as when highlighting the characters, I would highlight their ship's uniform colors. So Kirk got the yellow, Spock gets blue, McCoy got a different version of blue, Chekhov and Sulu get different varying versions of yellow, Uhura, Scotty both get red. That was just my way of recognizing who I was talking about. I'm a giant Captain Kirk fan. I think that's my favorite character in the series. And so it's been a lot of fun to try to do William Shatner's Kirk without obviously imitating him, but to give a sort of a feel of that guy. Spock's a lot of fun. And of course, with McCoy, you get that Southern sort of blasted Spock thing going on, which is always great. And naturally, everyone, I think, loves imitating Scotty because just doing the Scottish accent is just really fun. So what's the recording process like? Well, you know, I'm here in the studio and we just start reading the book out loud. I have an engineer and a producer out there, and she stops me a lot to tell me how I'm saying the Klingon words wrong and corrects me on how to do that, which is very important because I want to get them right. And it's just a fantastic time. We have a really fun time doing this, and we'll end some scenes and just laugh because it's just so fun to see these people or to be voicing these people again and having them brought to a new audience.
Captain's Log, Stardate 3950.1. The Enterprise is en route for some much-needed shore leave on Chippewa Prime. In the meantime, we find ourselves expecting a visit from a most distinguished guest, whom Mr. Spock knows far better than I. Leaning forward in his chair, the captain rested his elbows on the table and clasped his hands together. Mr. Spock, report. The Vulcan nodded. At our present speed, we should arrive in the Libro system in 17 hours, 34 minutes.
She's not exactly purring like a kitten, added Scott, but she'll get us there, Captain.
The engineer looked tired after the long hours he and his teams had been devoting to the ongoing repair efforts. Turning his attention to the engineer, Kirk said,
Well done, Scotty, getting the warp engines back online. How are your diagnostic checks coming?
We're getting there, sir. Not that I like the results we're seeing. I know what you're about to ask, and I have to warn you that anything past Warp 5 is begging for trouble. The engines will definitely need the sort of attention we can only get at a starbase.
His arms folded across his chest, McCoy asked, And what about you? How are you feeling?
Ridden hard and put away wet, Doctor, Scott mustered a smile. I promise I'm heading to my quarters for a few hours' sleep before getting back to it.
McCoy's eyes narrowed. At least five. Doctor's orders. Before the engineer could protest, he added, They can call you if they need you, but not unless the warp engines are about to explode.
There's still a lot of work to be done, Doctor, and I don't like being away too long when my lads are still at it.
I already know you've got them rotating through so everyone can get some rest, replied McCoy. Now it's your turn.
Then his voice softened. You trained your people well, Scotty. Let them do their jobs.